about 11:30 at night. I started at 3 a.m. this morning, so I am very tired. I was affected by flight cancellations and delays, but I am here. I am headed to passport control. I'm gonna grab my bag, get a taxi. Hopefully they're still running. I'm sure they are. It's a big city. And then headed home. Bulgaria, right now just walking up and down the tram street. And on first glance, I will say I don't think the city had a lot to offer. I was a little unsure about it, but the more time I spent here, the more I explored, I really found that it was a city with layers. There's just a lot more to it than what meets the eye originally. So if you do get here and you're like, just give it some time. It has a lot more to it. So there are lots of green spaces, there's a lot of parks. The restaurants even are like not what they seem like on the street. They usually go back a lot further. They have a lot more space. They're decorated very nicely. A lot of times you can even like have, there's like secret gardens, like outdoor areas that you can sit, have a drink or have a meal. So I've just really found that the more we've uncovered, the more that we've done different things, the more what we've really, really enjoyed it. So, Sofia is the capital of Bulgaria. It's sort of the western part of the country, and it's the bottom of the Vitosha Mountains. There is a mountain range very nearby for hiking. They are a part of Europe, but they are not in the Schengen zone, which is great for any digital nomads who want to stay in Europe but need to leave the Schengen area. So you can actually get 90 days here in Bulgaria outside of your Schengen visa. And then they also use the lev, so that's their currency. So they don't use the euro. And right now, the lev is like, one lev is like 50 cents. That's the exchange rate we're going on. So overall, I would say come give it a chance. It's a very interesting city once you get to know it. And it's a great destination for digital nomads, for your budget, but also a great place to work and hang out for an extended period of time. Always find really interesting in new cities is identifying what their quick food takeaway options are. And so I was really surprised in Sofia to see that it was pizza slices and gelato. So no matter where you are, you can get a pizza and ice cream throughout the city. There's also a lot of bubble tea options, which I was kind of surprised about as well. And then actually my favorite thing has been the homemade lemonades that you get at the restaurant. So all of the restaurants have this on their menu. It seems very specific to Bulgaria. And then whatever fruits are in season is usually what flavors that you can get of the lemonade or the iced tea. They're so good. They've been my favorite so far. There's also lots of quick takeaway coffee places. And then just, you know, talking about layers earlier, for quick convenience stores, you actually want to look down on the street level. Because a lot of times there's just a window that's on like the street level, and that's actually a convenience store. So these developed during communist times and people were trying to make some extra money, but they've kind of just continued in the city since. So it's kind of interesting because some cities, like Seoul, for example, you want to look up to not miss anything, but here in Bulgaria, you want to look down a little bit so you don't miss anything. Sofia, we have found the easiest way to get around is by walking and by scooter. So right here in the city center, they do have metros and tram stations, which you're welcome to use. They're very inexpensive and it's well connected, but we found right here in the center, they're not super useful, as usually you can walk somewhere faster than you can take public transit. So a way to get around that is that we have been using these Lime scooters. They're really fun to ride if you've never used one before. And they're really easy to use. So all you do is have to download the Lime app on your phone ahead of time, get it set up, find any scooter on the street, on the sidewalks around the city, scan the QR code, it's reserved, and you're ready to go. So we have taken it literally like all over the city, and it's a really, really good way to explore a lot at one time, especially if you want to get like a little bit further outside of your neighborhood. So that is how we've been getting around Sofia, but you do have other options if you are interested. Vitosha Boulevard, which is my favorite street here in Sofia. You can see it's just a pedestrian only street, and there are bars and restaurants and shops that you can go to. It's a very long street as well, especially here on the weekend like today. There's a lot of people out just enjoying their time in the city. So I was fortunate enough in my accommodation to live right off of Vitosha. Did not know that when I was booking it, but I absolutely love just walking straight onto the street every day. It's really quiet during the morning, which is nice and peaceful, and then it's not too loud at night. So booking accommodation, we actually used a company called FlatAway, and I highly recommend going with them if you are coming to the city. There is also Airbnb, but we really enjoyed our time with FlatAway. And then as far as safety in the city goes, it has been super safe. I haven't had any issues while I've been here. Never really felt even unsafe. It just feels like a very genuine, calm, chill city. I've quite enjoyed it actually. Now the only thing that you do want to pay attention to is the taxi scammers. So it's pretty well known that they're going to try to scam tourists. So when you're at the airport, there's a stand, a taxi stand. You can book your taxi through that so you know you're going to get the best rate. And then when you're in the city, you want to use either the Taxi Me or the Yellow app to call your, you can basically just book your taxi in advance, because if you try to pick it up on the street, chances are that they're not going to give you the best rate or the correct rate. So just keep those in mind when you come, but definitely check out FlatAway, Taxi Me, and the Yellow app. Sofia as a digital nomad and you're looking for a place to work, I have been working at the networking premium spot over off Gurkha Panorama. It's very close to Vitosha Boulevard, which is sort of the main city center of Sofia. It's an absolutely gorgeous space, which I'll give you a tour of here in just a second. It has really fast Wi-Fi, a ton of natural light, and they even have snacks and drinks that you can buy during your day if you need just a little pick-me-up. And they also offer a free beer if you're doing a late night session or just a little bit of transition to the end of the day. It is located up on the 6th floor of this building, and so they also have a rooftop, which is just really nice to kind of take a break, walk outside, maybe even do a little bit of work outside, and you can change up your location within the co-working space pretty easily as well. Necessarily want to work from a co-working space, you're still going to be able to find plenty of coffee shops and cafes in Sofia that you can work from. Some of them can be really small, but I've found ones like Coffee Fellows, for example, which has quite a bit of space and they have free Wi-Fi. So you should be able to find some options here in the city. And then your housing should also be good enough to work. If you're unsure, just always ask your host ahead of time before booking if you can, and just ask them to send you a speed test. But we haven't had any issues with Wi-Fi while we've been in the city. And considering that Nomad Fest happens in Bansko every year, I'm guessing that the Wi-Fi in Bulgaria is not really much of an issue.
Now, Bulgaria is in Europe, so what you're gonna need is the European adapters if you're coming to work to charge all of your electronics. And you can actually shop my Amazon store for all my favorite adapters, my favorite adapter pack, and I'll leave that description, or I'll leave the link down in the description below for that. Not least, when you come to Sofia, you're probably going to be looking for things to do in your free time. Don't worry, there is plenty. So of course there's Alexander Nevsky Cathedral, which is one of the main features of the city. If you go on any sort of city walking tour, they'll definitely take you by it, which I recommend doing early on. Really, in most cities that you visit, is doing one of the free city walking tours. It gives you a really good overview of the different areas to explore. You usually see a lot of the, you know, main highlights right off the bat and know where you want to return to, and it gives you a good overview and historical background of the city. And we found that for Sofia it was really helpful during our time here. On top of the free city walking tours, they also offer a communism tour here. So if you're interested about that time period in Bulgaria's history, you can learn more about that. Some other things you can do is just hang out in the parks during the daytime or nighttime. We did a couple of different wine tastings as well as a wine and paint night, which was really fun. And the Vitosha mountain, which is right, Sofia sits right at the bottom of that mountain range, so you can go do that. Or we also tried a lot of the different local dishes like makitsa, which are these dough ball, I don't know, they're so delicious. You can eat them for breakfast or dinner or whatever, whenever you want. You can find them all over the city. Then for some weekend or just like day trips near Sofia, you can go to the seven Rila lakes. We really, really enjoyed our time here. We did spend the night here at a hotel up at the top of the hill. I definitely recommend doing it for more than just a day. I would definitely do like at least a weekend there. It was really nice, and it was a really nice break from the city. This weekend, our group is headed up to the Seven Lakes in Bulgaria. We're only about 2 hours driving from Sofia, and we're staying in a lodge up at the top of the mountain tonight, and this is our transportation up there. So it's a really pretty cat. It is really pretty. We are enjoying the ride so far, but can't wait to get to the top and get our hike started and just hang out with the guys tonight. Top of the Seven Lakes hike. You can see there's a few behind me, some over here. Pretty much everywhere you look, there's just this beautiful, gorgeous lake in the Bulgarian mountains. Also visit the city of Plovdiv, which I haven't had time to do, but everyone tells me that I need to do it. So next time I come back to Bulgaria, that will be top of my list. You can also check out Bansko, which is one of the ski towns. During the winter, obviously, you'd go skiing. During the summer, there's still lots of hiking, and it's a nice village that you can go visit. It's also where the Nomad Fest is held, and so if you come for the Nomad Fest anytime in the future, that will be in Bansko. And then Bulgaria does actually sit on the coast of the Black Sea. So if it is summer and you want some beach time, you can head over to Varna or any of the cities on the coast and check that out. And a fun fact that you may not know, I didn't until we did some of these wine tastings, is that Bulgaria actually has a history of winemaking, and they have over 300 vineyards in the country. So you can do a little vineyard wine tour around the country as well. Traveled a few hours outside of Sofia today to visit some caves and some waterfalls. Right now we're at the Devikashka cave. The heat wave that is going through Europe has also hit Bulgaria, so we were looking for something cool and different to do. We hired a driver to take us out, which has been really nice and relaxing. But you can see this cave is huge. It's so big. It's really pretty, and it is much cooler than the rest of Bulgaria right now. There are just a few activities that you can do when visiting Sofia. I hope you found this video series and travel guide super helpful. You can download a PDF version of this down in the link in the description below. And be sure to subscribe so you don't miss next week's video, and I will see you then.